Will we see more murder convictions for drinking and causing deadly crashes?
It's a question many are asking after David Gurley was convicted of murder and sentenced to 26 years.
Tonight, WLKY's investigative reporter Dwayne Pullman takes a look. Dwayne?
Well, there's no question for years sentences for DUI have been getting harsher, but most of the deadly DUI crashes end in a manslaughter or lesser conviction. It's rare when a murder conviction sticks, like it did in the drunk driving case of David Gurley. David Gurley, convicted of being drunk when he crashed his SUV into a motorcycle, killing Gerald Goldsmith, gave a goodbye hug to his brother. Gurley had just been sentenced to 26 years in prison for murder.
I guess I love him. Ain't much to say. You know, in this situation, there was no winners. They lost, we lost, everybody lost.
Gurley was just the second person convicted in the last 2 years of murder in Jefferson County for drinking and driving and causing a deadly crash.
Most of our cases end up being manslaughter because either juries don't feel that someone should be found guilty of a murder for a DUI.
Well, the Jefferson County Commonwealth's Attorney's Office says it's not stepping up murder charges and DUI deaths. It is bolstered by the Gurley conviction.
It's not necessarily an office change. It's more of a we want to sort of spread the word to the public that you actually can be charged and convicted of murder for drinking and driving if you kill someone.
And Gurley's murder conviction, prosecutors say, should send a sobering message at a time of year when many will be celebrating good cheer.
If you drink and drive, that you're looking at spending the rest of your life in prison.
Now, across the country, states from California to New York are getting murder convictions and deadly DUI crashes, too. Meanwhile, prosecutors are increasingly charging others who allow someone to drive drunk. In Connecticut, for example, two teens are charged with reckless endangerment after they handed over the car keys to a drunk teen who then crashed that car and died. Again, these are a small number of the total DUI cases, but it is clear the way has been paved to send drunk drivers who cause deadly accidents to prison for the rest of their lives. I'm Dwayne Pullman, WLKY News.